Hey guys, today's video is all about Aurora Sync. It's as per request, and before I begin, a big shout out to all you guys. You've been a great audience. I've learned a lot by reading your comments and discussing stuff. Love you guys. A big shout out again. Thanks for being a great audience. Let's get to it. Aurora Sync. There are three main key features in this particular whole setup of Aurora Sync and your RGB on your computer. So the first is your system dedicated lighting. So you just go head on down to open your Armory crate, and you can see this triangle, not above the triangular Aurora Sync. You click on that, click on system, and you can go to lighting. Right here you get all your profiles dedicated only to your laptop. You can adjust your brightness here on the bottom right corner, and you can also increase and decrease the brightness by clicking on the function keys, function and F2 and F3, I believe. Alright, so here, if the first one is sync, this one is just normal static color. So this is your profile, you can set it to anything you want. You can change the color, you get this amazing color wheel and few presets you can choose from. My preferred color, blue, like always. And that's static. Then you got breathing, kind of, oh yeah, for this I'll off the lights. Then you get this breathing effect, and there is this, it has a very pulsive effect, stopping, and color cycle. Well, this just wheels around all the RGB cycles, 255, it just keeps changing whatever color it desires to choose. Now you can increase the speed of it, or you can make it really slow. And rainbow, well, this is directional. Again, this profile is only dedicated to your laptop, so be sure to check it out. It's actually pretty cool. You can adjust the direction the lights move in, and that's that. Then you get comet. Well, this is just that. It's, well, nothing particular. And then there is flash and dash, similar to comet. Then there's stars. Well, if you're high, you could do that. Kind of trippy. Then there's rain, like it's raining outside right now. I don't know how this could resemble rain. Anyway. Then you have something called reactive. And quite, oh. Wow, that's, well, that's just nice. Well, that's that. Then you get lasers. This is cool. I like this. Click on that, it goes to either side of the keyboard from where you press. So it just moves away. It's just pretty cool. And then there's the ripple effect. This is my favorite. And I've used this for Assassin's Creed. If I hold V and then the eagle vision just comes in on the screen, it's just nice to see. Favorite color again, turquoise. Then that's that for your computer. And then you get something called Aurora Sync. Now, when you click on Aurora Sync, it has two profiles. One is that it has a couple of presets, and it's mainly designed to integrate your other Asus devices, lighting and RGB, and you can control that. So you head on down to Aurora, and you just go to Aurora Sync, and they have similar profiles to that of the other one, the system one, so I'm just gonna skip out of that. This is music. Now, music is pretty good. Like, it synchronizes with the music you play. So if I were to open YouTube right here and just pick a video, say a song. I just type song right there, and okay, why not this? I don't know what this is. I've never heard this. We'll kind of fast forward. I think we should give gain to the volume. There you are. The more volume you give, the higher the lighting goes. If you really give it a maximum, it goes higher. All right, skip out of that. Okay, now you get something called smart. Now this you can adjust somewhere here. Right now my computer is running above 40 degrees, that's why it's yellow. Okay, above 60. Nice. So you adjust these, it'll change according to your computer's temperature. Then you get something called adaptive color. Now, personal favorite of mine, you can go to customize, and on customize, you click on load screenshot. Now, after you take a screenshot, by clicking on print screen on your computer, and then you focus by just dragging across the screen, and you click on save. Oops. Click on save. Now what it does is it takes the pixel average, if you select pixel average, on that spot. So right now, in this spot, which is on my display, it's going to take the average and display that. So look at that. So if I were to, oops, I just lost my screen recording again. All right, so now it's this. If I keep playing, the whole color is kind of grayish. See how it changes it according to what the screen displays. So that's that. And if we go back to Aurora again, there is the most common color in the detection area. Now if I were to go there and go back to Brave, it's the same thing, except like if you focus at that, the most prominent color will be the one that your whole computer displays. So that's that. And then there is dark. There's nothing. It's just dark. There is a final third feature that is you can customize it yourself. So there's something called Aurora Create, where you can create your own lighting. So you can customize if you just want the logo on, or you want these top light, I mean the bottom lights that come right down there. And if you just want these lights down here, I'll zoom out a little. So you can customize, you can just drag, select, and layer. I'll make another video on this, because this is going to take a whole different video to create. There's just a lot to do in this. So I made a couple of presets for you guys to see. If I were to select police lighting, if I were to play this, well, it's just something I made out of the blue. So that's that. Pretty cool. So if you were to go back, exit out of this, and go back and you were to select police lighting, keep it as that. We'll just keep repeating it in a loop. That is Aurora Sync in a nutshell. Like I said, I'll make the other video soon, the one that explains how you can create this, so stay tuned. So guys, that's it. That's Aurora Sync and your computer lightings in a nutshell. Give it a good like if you have liked the video. If there's something I've missed and you've discovered, go ahead and put it in the description, and I'm sure to put it in the next video. Till then, stay cool, and welcome to WASD Club.